Welcome back to the Island 54 Devlog. Today I invite you to join me as I add resource harvesting to the game. I'm currently making a beeline towards shelter construction in the game. Last episode I got started on the crafting system. Today I'll be adding trees and allowing the player to break the tree down into more manageable parts, which they'll later use to build their first shelter. I'll start by modelling a tree and all the different things it can be broken down into. I've shown some Blender montages before, but today I'll go into a bit more detail about how I actually build my models. If you're not here for that level of detail, feel free to skip it. I promise I won't be offended. As always, there are timestamps down in the description below. After Blender, I'll show you how I developed my harvesting system. And finally, I'll do a demo and talk a bit about what is coming up next. I started with a cube for the player reference, which I scaled to 2 meters on the Z-axis. I moved it up to be flush with the horizontal plane, then moved it away to make space for the tree. I wanted to have little stumpy bits where the player cuts branches off, so I started modeling the bare trunk first. I added a cylinder for the trunk, made it 0.5 meter radius and 10 meters tall, which seemed about right for a decent sized tree to me. I made it 12 segments so that it looked nice and faceted. 12 is also a good number because it has lots of factors, and you'll see why that's important in a moment. I moved the tree up by 5 meters and set the object's origin to be that base, because that's the point we want to use to place this into the world, not its midpoint. From edit mode, I scaled the top of the cylinder by 0.1 to make it more of a cone. I found out later that I could have actually used a cone instead of a cylinder, but I didn't know that at the time, and this worked just as well. Next, I needed the places that I was going to extend the branch cutoffs from, so I created 4 loop cuts to be the points that I'll actually have those cutoffs come from. I moved them until they looked about right, and the bottom one was just a bit above the player's head. Above each of those, I added another loop cut so that I had a nice face that I could extend the branch stubs out from. I wanted more branches at the bottom than the top. By having 12 segments in the original cylinder, it meant I could divide the trunk radially by 6, 4, 3, or 2, which are the exact numbers of stubs I went with at each level. For the bottom layer of stubs, I selected every second face, changed the reference system to normal so things could be manipulated relative to the individual faces instead of the tree as a whole, and extruded the faces out by about 10 centimeters. I then scaled each of those new faces by a little bit, then rotated them by anything from 30 to 60 degrees. I then repeated this extrusion and scaling to get something reminiscent of branch stubs. I then repeated the entire process for each of the other layers, this time with 4 stubs, then 3, then 2. I gave the trunk a fairly arbitrary brown material, and there we have a faceted tree trunk. I created a second simpler mesh to be used as the hitbox for this trunk. It's just a cylinder without the stubs and without a material attached. I duplicated the trunk so that I could start on a second version of the tree that had all of the foliage. From edit mode, I added another cylinder for the first layer of foliage. This time, it was a 3 meter diameter and 3 meter high cylinder, and slightly fewer segments. Adding shapes from edit mode adds them to the existing mesh rather than creating a new object. I gave it a green material and moved it roughly into place so that the player would have to crouch to get under it. I then scaled it from the top to give it a conical shape. Then I did a pair of insets from the bottom edges to allow me to make the bottom concave, which I think looks better. I extruded the new bottom faces, scaled them on the XY plane, then adjusted everything until the layer of foliage covered the branch stubs. I had to move the light into a better spot to really see what I was doing. For the next layer of foliage, I duplicated the first layer, moved it up the tree, and scaled it. I couldn't tell if the new layer would correctly cover its stubs, so I temporarily applied a transparent material to the bottom layer of foliage. Once everything looked about right, I repeated this process for the third layer. On the fourth layer, I scaled the top face to 0 to get a nice point up there, then jiggled all the foliage around so it looked a bit more natural. And there we have what I'm going to call a spruce tree for now. The hitbox for the full tree was formed out of a cylinder that I reshaped to roughly match the foliage. I then used the double inset trick again to punch out a bit from the bottom that became the lower trunk. Before moving onto the different stages of harvesting, I decided to model the outputs from the harvesting. I started with a stick, which is just a 3 meter cylinder and pretty self-explanatory. For a pile of needles, I just used a cone shape. These were simple enough to not need separate hitboxes. The sticks and needles won't necessarily come right from the tree though, so I wanted to also make a branch model, basically a stick with the needle still attached. I duplicated the stick and then used a cube to build up a thin trapezoid prism that represented the needles. I duplicated it and rotated it to make my finished branch. Now all I needed was the various states of undress for the tree, and these were really easy to make. I duplicated the full tree and its hitbox, selected the lower layer of foliage, and deleted it. I then moved and rescaled the hitbox to roughly match the new shape. I then rinsed and repeated until I was left with just the top layer. This time, instead of exporting the model as an FBX, I just saved the blend file directly, since I was going to have to pull out the individual meshes anyway. It turned out this was way easier than exporting, so I'll likely be working directly with blend files from now on. I added mesh filter, mesh renderer, mesh collider, and rigid body components to the new spruce tree prefab and dropped it into the world to take a look. I'm no 3D artist, but I'm pretty sure this looked like a tree. It was now time to start developing the harvesting system. The harvest system is driven by a new component, Harvestable, that is attached to items like trees. At its core, it contains an array of harvest stages, so that I can control which items get harvested at each stage and control model changes along the way. I keep track of the current stage, and whenever harvest is called, we increment the stage and instantiate any items that will have been harvested. The harvest stage itself stores an array of objects to be harvested during that stage, any tools the character might require, and describes any changes that should be made to the object items are being harvested from. So for trees, we can select different tree models as foliage is harvested. Harvested object stores the prefab that will be instantiated as a result of that harvest operation, and a bunch of other parameters like number of instances to generate and where they'll be placed in the world. The code to instantiate the harvested objects looks complicated at first, but all it's doing is choosing a random location and orientation within the parameters specified by the harvesting rules, then instantiates the new objects in those positions. The code to calculate the rotation uses quaternions. If you want to understand what quaternions are and how they work, I highly recommend 3 Blue 1 Browns videos on the topic. All you really need to know though is that if you want to compose a number of rotations one after the other, then you multiply their respective quaternions together in reverse order. Next, I implemented the harvest verb performer, which is as simple as it gets because all of its logic is handled by the harvestable component. It really just takes its parameters and then delegates everything to the harvestable component. I created prefabs for each of the items that could be harvested, branches, sticks, and piles of needles. The spruce tree is the most obvious example of a harvestable. It has 5 different stages. Stage 0 is the full tree with all 4 layers of foliage. Stage 1 uses a mesh with only 3 foliage layers and generates 6 branches about 3 meters off the ground. The next stage generates 4 a bit higher, then 3, then 2, with the final stage having no foliage. Each stage has varying droopiness in their rotations to give the effect a bit more variability. The branches themselves are also harvestable with just 2 stages, the base stage, which is the full branch, and a second stage where it becomes a stick and generates a pile of needles. So now it's time to try it out and see how it looks. I think this approach to resource gathering has a lot of potential. I think there's a bit more I could do on the inventory system to make it more compelling though. The branches and sticks should be stackable to varying degrees to encourage either breaking things down near the tree or where you're using the resources, depending on if you are trying to craft with sticks, needles, or both. Needles and other similar resources should be stackable in a different way, where rather than the number of items in a stack, you have a stack volume. It should also be possible to cut down the tree, maybe with a better axe, but maybe it would be possible to drag a smaller tree to where you need it, but bigger trees would need to be broken down in place, unless you have access to much more advanced transportation. This week's comment of the week comes from Skeptical Orange, who says, "Looks like this game is huge, keep it up." One thing I was hoping to do fairly early on that I haven't been able to do yet is work out what kind of game I'm making, in the hope that it will rein in the scale of this project, but I'm still just plodding along as though I'm building an MMO. If I don't have a flash of inspiration for how to make something smaller, I may just keep going until I've built an MMO. I really hope not though, because I'd rather spend a little while building a great game than ages building the perfect game. Next week, I'll be adding my take on land claims and a very rough approach to shelter construction. I'll then likely move on to something else for a while. I still haven't decided what I'll work on next. I could start looking at mobs, combat and survival, or work on multiplayer aspects of the game. Let me know down below if you have any opinions on what you'd like to see me work on next. Until then, happy game developing.